Let's look at the question number 10 of UGC NET paper 2. The question is saying, in a positive edge triggered JK flip-flop, if J and K both are high means J equals to 1 and K equals to 1, then the output will be what on the rising edge of the clock, which means K equals to 1, clock equals to 1, J equals to 1 and K equals to 1, and this is positive edge triggered JK flip-flop. Okay, let's look at the positive triggered JK flip-flop. We had SR flip-flop. Without this input, this is SR flip-flop. Okay, so we have modified SR flip-flop to construct JK flip-flop, because at this state S equals to 1 and R equals to 1, the output was undefined, it was unused. So to avoid that situation, we modified SR flip-flop to construct JK flip-flop. Okay, so when we have J equals to 0, clock equals to 1 and K equals to 0, then this becomes 0 becomes 1, so this is 1, 1 into 0 is 0, the complement of 0 is 1. Okay, now 1 0 1, this is 0, this is 0, 0 1 becomes 1. So in this case, output is unchanged, there is no change. The output is Q and Q naught, same as previous, okay, no change. In this state, when J equals to 0 and K equals to 0, there is no change in this state. This state is also called as memory state, okay, we can say memory state, because output is stored in this case, okay. Let's say J equals to 0. And K equals to 1 and clock is 1. So when we apply 1, clock is 1, clock is 1 and J equals to 1, J equals to 0, clock 1. So when we apply this, 0 into 1 is 0 and this becomes 1, 1 1 into 1 and this becomes 0. In this case, 1 0 becomes 0 1. Okay, in this case, when J equals to 0 and K equals to 0, output is 0 1. This state is called as reset state. When we apply J equals to 1 and K equals to 0 and clock is 1, this becomes 1 0. This state is called as set state. Okay, now we are interested in J equals to 1, K equals to 1 and clock equals to 1. Okay, let us assume Q equals to 0, then Q bar will be 1. Okay, let's run this diagram on this basis. Okay, J equals to 1, K equals to 1 and clock equals to 1. We are interested in this case. In question, they are asking about this case. In this case, when you apply J equals to 1, K equals to 1 and clock equals to 1, this becomes J equals to 1 and clock equals to 1, and the output of Q naught is connected here. The output of Q bar is connected to this. So these have 3 inputs and these 3 inputs are 1 1 1. So AND of 1 1 1 is 1 and NAND of 1 1 1 is 0. This becomes 0 and here 1 1 0. Because the Q is 0, J equals to 1, K equals to 1. So J equals to 1 and clock is 1, this becomes 1, 1, 0. Okay. So in this case, 1, 1, 0, AND of 1, 1, 0 is 0 and the complement of 0 is 1. So when we have 0 and 1 on NAND gate, it gives 1, 0. Okay. Now we apply Q equals to 1 and Q naught equals to 0. Okay, so this will become 1 1 0 and this becomes 1 1 1 because Q is 1 now and Q bar is 0. So this becomes reciprocal of each other. Okay, 1 1 0 and 1 1 1. So in this case, the output will be 0 and 1. So you can see, if you apply one more times, this becomes 0, this becomes 1. 0 is supplied here and 1 is supplied there, then becomes this becomes 111 and this becomes 110. So in this case output will be 10. So if you see the output after every clock, the output is changing from 1 to 0, 0 to 1, then 1 to 0, 0 to 1. So I can say this state is Qn plus 1, next state is the complement of last state. This condition is called as toggle. Okay. So the answer for this question is toggle.